qualifiers out here at Gulf Coast Speedway. 97 Cassie Cole takes the lead, charging away at turn two in front of number 39 of Holly Spink. Cassie Cole got a sizable lead as it is after one lap. The four car, David Spencer, does get around that number 39 of Holly Spink. Charges into second place.
That 97 looks really strong going to turn 3 and 4. It looks like David Spencer has something to come. Has some speed, making up some time up on Castle Cone.
I don't quite know if there will be enough laps in this heat race for David Spencer to catch up, but he might have something when the feature comes later tonight.
Exactly. David Spencer has something underneath the hood that can't possibly stay with Castlecombe in the feature race later on tonight. And right now it's just showing that he's able to make up some time to catch up with Castlecombe. But like what Marvin said, we may be a few laps short to actually do that in the heat races, but at least he knows that he has some speed underneath that hood. John Mims. And on the back of the pack is going to be number 777. And we're green coming out of four. Harper Johnson has that first place position going into turn four. Or one, excuse me. It looks like Corbin Weekly is making a pass on the inside, taking over that second place position. Side by side down the backstretch going to turn 3 and 4 with Mims and number 88.
And number 88 is trying to make the pass on the outside. Can't seem to get it to stick. Moves in behind. Maybe get a draft into the turn. Doesn't seem to be able to get any speed.
Maybe try to set up a crossover move going to turn 1 and 2 and then going out of turn 2 underneath. But he slips up going underneath the lap car of the 077 of Callie Woodrow. So down the back stretch, it's Harper Johnson, Corbin Weekly, and Mims 1, 2, and 3 coming out of turn 4. Corbin Weekly looks on the outside trying to make a pass on Harper Johnson. Can't quite do it. Harper Johnson closes the door. He's going to try to look on the inside coming out of turn 2.
Gets to the door bumper. Tries to make the pass outside. They go into turn 3 side by side. John Mintz tries to make it 3 wide. Can't make it stick. White flag is out on the track. 53.43H of Harper Johnson still in the lead. This is the time to make the pass. Tries to make it on the outside, doesn't have enough to get to the side of it.
And going into turn 3 and 4, Weekly looks on the outside. So does Mims looks on the outside too. Let's see who has it, but Harper is going to hold on to that win and win the heat race.
You could throw a blanket over that 1, 2, and 3. What a race.
Yeah, 1, 2, and 3, they were right beside each other. Mims had something going for him, but he got a little loose.
Green flag here. Green flag is underway here at Gulf Coast Speedway. But an action-packed start. Here. 09 of Autumn Pedraza takes the lead with the 343C of Carly Johnson in tow.
Separated from each other as they come out of turn 4, but it looks like Carly Johnson has something for our leader.
Yellow flag is out as we have a car stopped on the back stretch.
On a four. Green flag racing. Going to turn one and two. Autumn Petraza is going to lead this pack as they exit out of turn two down the back stretch. Carly Johnson's on the outside making a move.
Carly Johnson tries to make the pass stick out of turn four. Might need a little bit more speed to make the pass. Might get it out of turn two. Looks like she will. Does make the pass out of turn two. Has her eyes set on the 0-9, Autumn Petraza.
Now, Autumn Petraza is like a sitting duck out there as Johnson's making a move underneath, going to turn one and two. Johnson, it looks like it's the Johnson & Johnson show on the Mini and Mighty class as we have number 20 stopped out of turn four on the outside.
Let's go, Autumn!
Of Kinsley.
Green flag is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway. You can throw a blanket over the top four. The 343 is trying to make a move on the 09. Gathering up some speed.
All right, so they're going on turn one and two. Carly Johnson tries to make a move underneath Autumn Petraza as they pass up lap traffic. Johnson has a nose underneath, but Petraza has closed it off.
White flag is out here tonight.
Let's see if Johnson has anything on this last lap to make the move for this heat race.
Diving into turn three.
Johnson look underneath, but she gets squirrely. And Autumn Petraza is going to hold on to the lead for this heat race win, for heat race number one.
Is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway. Monkey Creasy takes the lead with 00. Weston Crabtree in tow. Now the race is on. Monkey Creasy still maintains the lead going into turn four. Slides up the track, it looks like. Has a wide turn out of turn four.
Looks like Ashton Hart in third place has something for Weston Crabtree as he was gaining position on the backstretch but loses some going into turn three and four and going down the backstretch. Or going down the front stretch, excuse me. So Ashton Hart's all over Weston Crabtree. That seems to be the battle where it is right now. As they come to turn three and four, Hart has something, but gets a little squirrely going into the turn, but makes a strong run down the outside of the front stretch in the turns one and two. White flag is in hand for Monkey Creasy.
Weston gets a little slippy coming out of turn four, maintains second place. Monkey Creasy looking to get her heat win tonight. Dives into turn three. Monkey Creasy will win her heat.
Side by side, Hart goes underneath, makes the pass on Weston Crabtree.
What a pass for second place.
Second place away from Jason Creasy as they go to the third floor.
top four, the 53 of Jason Creasy.
Wow, that was a nice save by Dennis. Dennis.
And we're green flag here. Bradley Yates makes a pass on the outside. Keeps his speed. Gets Creasy up to the wall.
Coming to a stop down at an exit of turn two, and there's going to be a yellow flag.
Green flag is out here. Gulf Coast Speedway. They pull back in. The orange cone. The
19. driving for Lawrence Mann. He's usually the driver of that car. It looks like Lawrence Mann does not mind having him put in that race car. He's just checking himself out and this guy hit the tire on the end of the turn four.
Stretch, empty,
down on the inside going to turn one and two. Down the back stretch, looks like Ronnie Shepard's going to ride that hill around. Look, make himself look big, so 57 will back himself off and make the pass.
57 gets a little bit loose, gets the wheels on.
Side by side, 57. Schultz gets in second, and Rachel's in third place. Graham Gilbert gets in fourth place, and rounding out the field, it's going to be the 29T of Dan Tuck. We're on turn four, and we are getting started. Corbin Weekly gets started, and the first place position is 343. Harper Johnson is going to be in that second place position. As they move down the backstretch, Harper Johnson is getting closer and closer ever so slightly. She's got to hold on to that her line, the smooth line, and she'll be able to make that pass, I do believe.
That Legends car looks good racing out here tonight. That 343 car looks to make the pass on the outside. Looks like the fast line around this track for these cars on the inside. Might get to see the bumper used.
Oh, and the top blows off of Carly. Carly Johnson.
That will slow that car down a tad.
I think there's a bit of a drag on that car right now.
Acts as a wing, that is.
You see that sometimes in stock car racing where the hood comes up and at least it's not in front of the driver on the Carly Harper Johnson's car. I wonder if she was the one that was supposed to put the clips into that top on her go-kart. Oh, she's getting passed on the outside.
That's definitely slowing her down. I hate to be the one that was supposed to clip those down. They might get a stern talking to by this driver.
All right, so Corbin Weekly has a great advantage as he does not have a drag issue with the top of his car. And he's going to make some more time on the second place car around this racetrack.
Probably a huge draft behind that 343 car. If you did manage to get behind her, you'd probably just draft right up to her.
Alright, so John Mims is moving ever so slightly on Corbin Weekly. Closer and closer each and every lap. I think he's running out of time in real estate. But he is running a little bit faster than what Corbin Weekly is.
White flag is out. That car's got to feel a lot different to drive with that so much drag on the back. And the checkered flag is out for the 777 of Corbin Weekly. And green flag is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway beneath this beautiful night. I love all the American flags.
And we got go-karts all over the place. This is unusual for Gulf Coast Speedway. It's a great turnout for these mighty karts. As we come down the front stretch, 343 is going to be in the lead going into turn one and two. Carly Johnson. Carly Johnson holds on to that first place position, and it looks like the 06 of Ashton Hart is going to be in that second place position. And Oliver Trout is going to be in third of the 09.
This will be a 10 lap feature. Looks like Carly Johnson is on a tear.
Monkey Creasy has a bit of a run coming out of turn four. Going down the front stretch into turn one and two, which he's gaining some ground. Meanwhile, it is all Carly Johnson right now, and she's going to come up on lap traffic and see how she can handle this lap traffic.
As always happens in dirt racing, lap traffic can make your race or break your race. She does catch some lap traffic as Ashton Hart makes the pass on the outside. What a good pass on the outside, using that lap traffic as a pick almost.
Carly Johnson tries to hold on to the second place position as Ana Pedraza moves into that second place position and holds and gets caught up in lap traffic herself.
We do have a car stop coming out of turn two. It is the 343C of Carly Johnson. Green flag is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway.
See how they go on to turn one. Ashton Hart has the first place position, but it looks like Monkey Creasy's right behind Ashton Hart. Monkey Creasy's gaining some ground going to turn one and two. Monkey Creasy's trying to make a pass going to turn three and four, but is unable to make up any ground going down that backstretch. They're exiting out of turn four. Weston Crabtree having some company. Caroline Sanders behind Weston Crabtree in the double zero. Gaining some ground going down the backstretch. Backs off just a little bit, but Weston Crabtree gets a little loose. Caroline Sanders is able to gain more ground as she's going to look to the outside, but ducks back underneath his lap, to pass lap traffic on the outside, or on the inside of lap traffic. And it looks like Caroline Sanders makes that pass on the outside, finally going into turn three and four. And we have a stalled car.
Green flag is back underway here for the green-white checker. Ashton Hart is in the lead with Monkey Creasy in second, but oh, beating and banging.
Wow, that was Caroline Sanders that pulled underneath, took that second place position. She's charging hard on the outside, going up to Ashton Hart, trying to make that pass.
Yellow flag is out as we have a car stopped in turn one. That's a 24 to get up into second place before the yellow didn't come out and does make the pass diving into turn one. And it looks like we'll catch up to Ashton Hart. But catching up and making the pass is two different things.
Meanwhile, in the back of the pack, Carly Harper is making her way around.
White flag is out
for that fourth place position.
As I said, passing and catching up are two different things, as I think Ashton Hart will get this feature win.
Oh, no!
What a win for the 24 car.
Ashton Hart got loose, went over the tire. I'm glad he kept it on all four wheels, but that is a tough loss for Ashton Hart.
What a race win for Carolyn Saunders. Green flag is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway. 97 of Cash Money Lacombe is in the lead with the 39 of Holly Spake in tow. The 4 of David Spencer does make the pass on the inside. Will make a charge at Cash Lacombe. The 4 in the 97 really, this was the big race in the heat. Holly Spake will not give up. Trying to make a pass into turn four. Doesn't have to speed off of turn four.
So Cash Lacombe's way out of the lead, making some real estate as he goes into turn three and four. And David Spencer's in that second place position. It was Holly.
Holly Spake did get loose off of turn two and does flip.
Oh!
flag is out.
Cash money, trying to cash in some money on this race. As Dan Spencer has another thing in mind, trying to catch up to Cash Lacombe. David Spencer, strong into turn 3 and 4, coming down the front stretch. Going to turn 1 and 2, gain some ground on Cash Lacombe. And in that third place position is the Type Pool.
Ray of Ty Fulham is in third place, 13 of Chase Raper is in fourth place, and the third out of Holly Spang is in fifth.
Just to see Holly Spang out there still, it's always amazing to see all these mini sprints roll over and stuff, and then get back over and keep on going. Usually when you watch the sprint cars, you roll over, flip over, and they're not able to keep going. It's good to see her out there at least race for points tonight, and get back out there next week and continue racing. Meanwhile, up front, Cash Lacombe staying on the lead. And David Spencer really strong in turn 3 and 4. Was not able to catch any ground as he comes down the front to the back stretch. Really smooth out of turn 3 and 4. Oh, we got someone spinning out. Turn 2. Spun out, excuse me. Green flag racing. Cash Lacombe goes up turn 1 and 2 with Cash Lacombe in first. And in second is David Spencer. Holly Spakes in third. Let's see if she can hold on to that third place position. Going wide around turn 4. And Chase Raper makes his nose stick underneath Holly Spake as they go into turn 3 and 4. Holly Spake tries to hold on to that fourth place position. He's managing to hold on to that fourth place position. Cash Lacombe going to 1 and 2. Holding on to that advantage.
Cash Lacombe with a big advantage. Almost a straightaway. He's cruising out for his big money win. The white flag is out here at Gulf Coast Speedway. Cash Lacombe.
As it's easy money for this last lap, he's way out in the lead, and Cash Money Holmes is going to get his checkered flag.
Cash Lacombe wins the feature tonight for the juniors division. David Spencer in second place, Jace Raper in third.
We're going green flag racing. Dan Tucker gets the early lead on the turn 1 and 2. Dan Tucker holds on, going down the back stretch. He gets a good jump down the back stretch, going to turn 3 and 4. Lawrence Mann gets a run off of turn 3 and 4. He gets a run off from the 171. And go briefly three wide down the front stretch. Now, meanwhile, down the back stretch, they go double wide for 2, 3, and 4, and 5. 2, 2, 3. Just moving on up. tries to make it stick on the back stretch, and they're side by side going to turn 3 and 4. Dustin Hamilton holds on to that first place position as they go to turn 1 and 2 down the back stretch. Jason Creasy pulls off the racetrack going to turn 4. Stop in the infield, not the backstretch, excuse me. Into turn 1 and 2. Spreading his feet out. And it looks like Dustin or this bumper has something on it. Catch down to him ever so slightly.
Thank you.
on the outside. And we got yellow flags.
Yeah, the car flipped in turn two.
Thank you.
14-0.